So we did it. This is my new Project Jeep. I'm really excited. I think it's gonna bring some really cool new sick angles to the channel. This is a 2016 Jeep Rubicon Hard Rock Edition. It has all the fancy bells and whistles and trim packages of the Hard Rock, and it has the off-road capabilities of the Rubicon, because I haven't decided yet how far I want to take this thing. It depends on the interest on the channel, but like I said, 2016, this only has 13,500 miles on it. It's basically brand new, and I didn't sell the cert. This is just a second car, which means I'm gonna have, you know, a second insurance payment. And being a YouTuber is interesting whenever you buy anything, because everyone's always like, "Duh, bad idea, Max." You know, if you're a celebrity, it's like Beyonce drives around like maybe $400,000 Rolls Royce SUV, and it's like, "Yes, bitch, slay, queen, yes." You know, if you're a rapper, it's like, "Threw $30,000 on her titties last night." Everyone's like, "Yeah, $30,000 on her boobs. Goals, man." But I'm like, "Hey guys, I think this brings some value to the channel. I used to be really into Jeeps back in the day. It's kind of cool to relive a lot of my youth. I think it's gonna be like a lot of fun." Everyone's like, "Boo! Boo, Max! Poor financial decision, man! Should have spent this money on some, throw it on some tits, man." You know, I'm not gonna lie, I feel like a 17-year-old high school girl. Oh my god, my dad just bought me this Rubicon. It's so cute. Look at it. I took the doors off. The top's down. It's got locks. Wow, it actually locked. But there's no doors, so the whole security thing is a lack, right? But people are like, probably like, "Well, Max, why didn't you get the four-door, Max? The four-door is so cool." I already have a four-door car. This is a toy. Why would I get two four-doors? By the way, this back seat, it's only gonna be a two-seater. I'm taking this out. You know why? That's dude's spot. And then I'm gonna get like a little woofer protector, because I can't have dude falling out. He'd have a bad time.
All right, so I still have no idea what I want to do with this diet. You know, we leaned up for the Caymans, right? For all my friends that didn't care how lean I was and that wanted me to drink more margaritas and get back to my previous diet state. And now, like, I don't know. You know, I think I'm gonna, I want strength. I want that heavy deadlift. I want to be strong. It's not gonna happen for bench or squat. To be honest, guys, like, what's the point? I hit a 500-pound squat. Like, how strong do you think these things are gonna get? It's not gonna happen. Like 550, 600? No. By the way, barbecue and sweet and spicy sriracha, the only two sauces you need at Chick-fil-A. If you think you need Polynesian or Chick-fil-A sauce, why don't you just unsub my channel right now?
Taking some burn thermogenic. If you've never taken burn, it has pepper extract in it, and it's the only way I can describe it is it's like oddly satisfying, because you're drinking it and you're like, what is, stings the nostrils, like it's like a burning sensation, but after you like kind of get used to it, you're like, I like it. Hitting a push workout with my boy Shali, but he just got his car wrapped, so I want to go check it out. Looks sick, dude. How are you feeling back in the Caymans? You're competing again, right?
Yep.
When?
15 days. Already at 75 carbs a day.
Idiot.
Feeling like shit, bro. What matters? I'ma just dive right into the wild side. And I'ma ride the wave until I die. Until I die.
Well, that was easy. Man, having this 10,000 square foot warehouse with all this space just makes it a breeze to pull cars in here. Guys, we are ready to install our first mod. What's interesting about this Jeep is that it is the Hard Rock Rubicon, which means that it is like pretty much their top tier package. I don't think they have one that is like, you know, a higher cost out of the factory. And it has all the bells and whistles. It has like the premium sound system. It has the subwoofer. It has all of the, you know, the off-road features, the sway bar disconnects, the locking differentials, the lower gear transfer case, power windows. What a luxury, right? But it has this head unit. Like, what? This doesn't make any sense. I think whoever owned this actually sold the touchscreen that came with it, maybe for a couple hundred bucks, and swapped it with one of these old ones, because there's no way they would have all these features, the premium sound system, and then you would have this head unit. I mean, an aux cord? I forgot how these things work, and I almost set the car on fire because my playlist was too lit. No? Okay, well, we have a solution. I give to you the ILX 207 Alpine touchscreen Apple CarPlay ready. I mean, Android if you have a, what kind of loser has, this is gonna be the replacement. Let's go ahead and install it. By the way, this was $1,000. So whoever took that out, thanks, man. First, we take this off. Then we take this out. This doesn't look too important. Wow, Max, your mechanic skills are so attractive. Thanks. Oh my gosh, how did you know what to do, Max? Because I know everything. Goodbye, you piece of crap. Ow, bitch.
1 hour later.
Hey, dude, you've been helping me out, man, and look who else helped out.
What up, dude?
So we got the head unit all in. We're gonna see if it works right now. Moment of truth, this looks like a whole cluster. Please, God. Hey, check it out, it works. I have never had Apple CarPlay before. Is it actually that nice?
Yeah, oh yeah. Especially like top down, you're cruising, you don't mess with the shit.
Working. Shows if the door is open, shows the tire pressure.
Check that shit out.
Rev that bitch. Whoa!
That's pretty sick, honestly.
Yeah, of course it's sick, I bought it. All right, so dash is all put back together. The first Jeep mod, and it wouldn't bring me back to old times if we didn't already lose a dash bolt. So there's one missing. One gripe that I do have is I would prefer this have like a volume knob rather than little buttons. But you know what? Beggars can't be choosers. But thank you guys for tuning into this Jeep mod, and I'll see you in the morning.
Hold on. Is this the same video you unveiled it?
Yeah.
You didn't mod the first video?
Yeah. I'm giving people everything. Guys, I need to know what you like. Do I put this thing on 40s? Do I spend an absurd amount of money? Give the video a thumbs up. Like, give me like 15,000 thumbs ups if you want to see this Jeep, like, out of this world awesome. Or just don't give me 15,000 likes if you just want it kind of cool. So, see you in the morning. So the repair people just stepped out to go to Home Depot. They're fixing this right now. I didn't show you this last time, but the seal on the bottom of the window, it like started separating. So that's really sick. And then check out what they're doing with these water spots. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go watch my last video. But the water spot that was there, they just painted over it. So that's cool. Let's go check out my bathroom. Woof! All they've done is paint over the mold. I guess they wiped it down. I didn't see any like bleach. So I don't know what they're doing to make sure this doesn't like be a reoccurring thing, because you can't just put a Band-Aid over an issue like that. I told them I want a specialist or an inspector to come out and run a test for mold and contamination in the ceiling and the ducts, and then I want to see the full report because I care about, dude. By the way, have you guys noticed how white my teeth are? Do you see? I've been using these white strips recently. I try to do these like twice a year. I just get the store brand. I've gotten like the Crest ones before, but to be honest, these are the same thing.
No, they're not, Max. You can't get store brand. Yes, you can, Becky. Yes, you can. Thank you.
So I haven't actually low bar squatted in a couple weeks. I've been taking it off, obviously with the vacation, but even before that, I've just been doing like leg press and whatnot because I had this weird like tightness in like the upper middle of my back, like in my lat almost. And with the low bar, when I go down, like the entire movement, it just really gets in my head and it doesn't hurt. It's just like this like knot. Like, I do not like the way that it feels, and it messes me up because I had the strength to go up heavier, but like the whole time, that's all I'm thinking about it, so it just screws me up. So I might take a break from squats for a little bit longer, keep working on it, rolling it out. I'm gonna go see a specialist on Monday. For now, we'll just do some leg press. It's really easy in your training to kind of get cocky and get a little ignorant to like your body giving you signals, especially like myself, who I have the internet judging every single thing I do, judging my progress, judging what I look like, how strong I am, how many reps that I hit. I haven't hit a PR recently, but I've come to learn over the years of training. I've been lifting for like, I know you probably can't tell, but I've been lifting for like 7 years. And if I get to a point where like something's bothering me, instead of being like, oh no, I'm just still gonna squat because I'm a man, dude, I'm just gonna put it on there and I'm gonna push through it. It's like, no, I'm not. I'm gonna do some leg press. If I take some time off from the squat for 1, 2, 3, 4 months to let my body heal and I have to do something else, then I'll do it. So I would advise you to do that. Don't let your ego overtake your body, because we're trying to do this fitness thing for a long time. You're gonna be doing this for hopefully the rest of your life. I hope we all live long and healthy lives, but there's no reason to like get to a point where you can't lift anymore because you're ignorant. Don't ever be ignorant. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm gonna wrap it up here. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. The dog barking at me. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. If you're not new to the channel, then smash thumbs up button. What are you waiting for? Hope you guys are excited about the Jeep build. Again, I think you bring a lot of cool just content to the channel, and I already have a couple sick ideas in the works. So it's just another thing for you to follow in the world of Max. You can now watch Dude grow up, you can now watch the Jeep grow up, and you can continue to watch me just stay mature. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace.